Hey everyone, Itay Manero here, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through all the new features in Procreate 5.2 and how to use them, so let's jump right into it. Procreate 5.2 was just released a few days ago, and it comes packed with a bunch of new and interesting features. I'm going to leave a link in the description to the official Procreate website so that you can see a preview of what's new there. But I'm also going to give you a tour through all these new features one by one and explain how you can use them. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions about any of these tools, and I'll do my best to give you answers. The main feature in this update that everyone is talking about is the ability of painting on 3D models like if they were tri-dimensional canvases. This is a great addition to Procreate for those 3D artists that want to be able to paint and texturize their 3D models on the go. If you're not a 3D artist, I'm sure there's places on the internet where you can download 3D models you can paint on. But the cool thing is that Procreate offers a few free 3D models that you can download from the app and start painting right away. You can get them by clicking on the What's New tab on the top of the gallery, or if you missed it the first time and now that button is gone, you can still access it from the Actions menu in the Help tab. When you find it, click on Download Model Pack, and you get these 8 3D models. Painting on these 3D models in Procreate is as intuitive as painting on a regular 2D canvas. All you have to do is grab any brush you want, tap on the part of the model you want to paint, and start painting. You have almost all the belts and whistles from Procreate at your disposal. You can create layers, clipping masks, you can lock the alpha in your layers, use filters, and so on. Right now, the most important feature that is missing is using symmetry when painting the 3D models. The developers have said that this is a feature they want to add at some point, but it is apparently very difficult to implement. They've also said this is the first iteration of 3D painting in Procreate, and that they will keep on improving it, so let's hope we can see more features on this over time. Another thing that is not possible right now is to add text in the 3D models. I think this is not as important, because we can import images into the 3D models. This is super useful to add illustrations you have done previously on a 2D canvas and place them in your 3D model. Using this method, you could create any text you want on a blank 2D canvas, save it in your photo gallery, and then import it into your 3D model. This is also useful for importing photo textures, like wood and other materials, and add them to your models to achieve this photorealistic look. Speaking of materials, there's a new category in the brush library where you will find 17 new brushes specifically made to paint on your 3D models. With some of these brushes, you will be able to paint with different material effects, like metallic and roughness. This is actually a feature that you can use on any brush you want, as there is this new materials tab in the brush studio, where you can assign any metallic or roughness levels to your brushes. This opens up a lot of possibilities for brush makers like me, and I can't wait to see what new type of brushes I can create in the near future. Previous tools like the reference window will now adapt when working on a 3D model, allowing to have a secondary view of the 2D texture that updates when painting the 3D model, a secondary view of the model from any angle we want, or just any image we want to import to have it as a reference while painting. The most interesting part for me about the 3D painting feature is the ability to import my own 3D models to give them full life with color and texture. If you're wondering how can you create these 3D models, I have to warn you that I'm not a 3D expert, and that 3D modeling is an entirely different animal than painting. But if you're interested in learning, I recommend to check out an iPad app called Nomad Sculpt. For me, it is the best and easier to learn 3D modeling program, and there is a few YouTube channels dedicated to offering tutorials for beginners. I personally like the Southern GFX channel, since they have the tutorials from which I'm learning the most myself. You can find the link to that channel in the description of this video. One important thing that you need to have in mind is that for being able to import any 3D models into Procreate, these models need to have UV maps incorporated. UV map, as I understand, is this 2D texture that is wrapped around our 3D object, and that is the surface where we are actually painting on. Think about it as a decorative gift paper wrapped around a box. The problem is that you need to generate this UV map before importing the 3D model into Procreate, otherwise the app won't be able to open it. Apparently, UV mapping is quite a difficult task that I'm still trying to figure out myself on how to do it properly. I've tried with Blender, which is a free program, on my Mac, with not so great results, probably because I have no idea of how to use Blender. The easiest way I've found so far to do this, without any UV mapping knowledge, is to open the 3D model in Photoshop on my Mac, click on this Generate UV button, and let the program automatically manage the thing. Then I export the 3D object and I can import it in Procreate. Something I've noticed when I import my own 3D models is that Procreate automatically lowers the resolution of my model texture to 2048 by 2048 pixels. If you look at the 3D models Procreate provides, their texture is double the size, 4096 by 4096 pixels. Having a higher resolution in the texture is important because it will allow you to paint with more detail. While with a lower resolution you can see that the brush strokes look very pixelated. I'm sure I'm doing something wrong when creating my UV maps due to my lack of knowledge about 3D. Luckily, I contacted the Procreate team regarding this issue and they gave me the solution. You have to export your 3D model in OBJ format from Procreate to the Files app. Procreate creates a folder with all the files from this OBJ that includes the textures. All you have to do is import these 3 PNG textures in Procreate and change their size from 2048 by 2048 to 4096 by 4096, making sure to have resample activated. Then export them as PNG again and overwrite the original textures in the OBJ folder with these new textures. It is important that these new textures have the exact same names as the original files. Once you have done all that, you can drag and drop the OBJ folder back into Procreate, and the new model will have the 4K textures. I have tried and you can even get 6K textures with this method, but as far as I know, it only worked on my M1 iPad Pro. When I imported that same model with 6K textures into my newest iPad Mini 6, the app said that a more advanced device was required, so it is important to have the limitations of your device in mind. Another cool feature that has to do with the new 3D tools is Lighting Studio. You can find it in the Actions menu under the 3D tab that is available when you have imported a 3D model into Procreate. This will open a setup where you can add different lights around your model and adjust their values. You can change their color, intensity, delete them or duplicate them. You can also move them around and place them wherever you want. You can have 4 lights in total. Additionally, you can control the intensity of the light in the environment and choose from 11 different environment types that will change the way the light affects your model. When sharing the painted 3D models, we have a few new options. You can export just a still image of your current view. But the most interesting one for me is that you can export a short looped video with an animation of your model rotating. You can choose different resolutions for the video. Change the type of animation between rotate and swing. Change the animation duration. Modify the zoom distance. And the intensity in the movement of the rotation. You can show or hide the background too. Now, when you double-click on any brush to open Brush Studio, we have this whole new section called Stabilization. Procreate had some kind of stabilization before. It was called Streamline, and it is still available here, but now we have 3 different types of stabilization that we can use individually, or even in combination with each other. Let's see what each of these do. I have this brush that at the moment doesn't have any kind of stabilization turned on. Imagine for a moment that I have a very shaky hand, and I'm trying to draw a straight line. This is an exaggeration, but it could look something like this. Let's now slide the streamline option all the way up, and see what it does. I'm going to do another straight line with the same amount of shakiness as before. As you can see, it helps to reduce the shakiness of my line, but it is still noticeable. This is the way stabilization has always worked in Procreate until now. It helped a little, but it wasn't perfect. Let's try now the other two new options. According to the Procreate team, the stabilization slider mimics the way this feature works in other programs like Photoshop, Clip Studio Paint and so on. If I turn it all the way up, and I draw another straight line with the same amount of shakiness as before, this is what happens. You can see that my line is way better than before. You can barely see any shakiness. Let's see now what the last option does. According to the Procreate team, motion filtering is a new way in which they try to tackle stabilization with some other type of calculations different from other programs. If I do another straight line with the same amount of shakiness as before, this is the result. It may be a little hard to see, but I would say that this is the best looking line out of the four. It really got rid of any shakiness. Obviously, you don't want to use any of these sliders at their maximum amount, but this is a totally personal preference. I would recommend you to try them out and see what works best for you. I personally find that with a 20-30% of motion filtering, I get a nice result of smooth lines without modifying or interfering too much with my line work. If you're wondering what this expression slider does, I think it tries to add more expressivity or personality to your curves. As always, this is a nice thing to have in case you want to try it out and see if you like it, but I recommend to use this kind of feature sparingly. If you don't want to modify any specific brush to work with stabilization, you can also customize a general preset that will work with any brush universally. You can find it in the Actions menu under Pressure and Smoothing. In Procreate 5.2, we have now a new addition to the brush menu. If you go all the way up, you'll find this new recent category with a star icon. This tab contains a history of the last brushes you have used. If you swipe on any of these brushes to the left, you'll see a few options. You can find where the original brush location is. You can also pin the brush so that it stays there for quick access. You can also unpin it if you don't need the quick access anymore. Or you can clear the brush from the history. Another update to the brushes is the fact that now we can save presets in the size and opacity sliders. Choose any size you want to save, and then tap on this plus icon in the preview corner. You can tap on the minus icon in the corner to delete this saved preset. This works in the opacity slider as well. You can save up to 4 presets on each slider and establish different presets for the brush, the smudge and the eraser tools. These presets are specific to each brush, so you can go crazy and customize all your brushes to your preferences depending on the way you use them. A nice addition to this update is Page Assist. You can find it in the Actions menu. It is similar to the Animation Assist feature in the sense that it transforms every layer or layers group into an individual page that you can navigate in this bar at the bottom. So it's basically like having a document with multiple pages. This is going to be great for working on storyboards or for making comics, where you need to have multiple pages accessible at once. You can duplicate pages, rearrange them, or delete them with this quick access. By the way, I'm sure this feature is going to be absolutely great in combination with my comic panels, balloons, and sound effects toolkit for Procreate, as you can see me using it here. Check it out, you can find the link in the description below. Taking advantage of the new Page Assist feature, we can now import PDF files right into Procreate. When doing this, Procreate will activate Page Assist automatically, allowing us to navigate all the pages in the PDF, and also edit them or draw and write on them. Of course, you can export the PDF again once you have finished editing. With the new update, there's a few new accessibility features included. For example, we have now two different ways of viewing our color palettes. Compact is the way it was before, but if you tap on cards, you will see this new view where the colors are displayed bigger, and Procreate automatically assigns a name to each color. If you tap on one of those names, you can edit it, and name every color anything you want. This could be super useful if you want to save colors for different parts of a character and things like that, and name them for easy identification. It also works when detaching the color window. In Animation Assist, you can now change the colors to the previous and next frames to any colors you want. If you go to the Procreate settings inside your iPad settings, there's a few extra options for accessibility here. you can activate this complementary floating window that you can place anywhere you want, and it will allow you to perform some gestures with a single touch. For example, you can zoom in and out, or pan in any direction with one finger. You can fit the canvas to the screen, and also undo and redo. Activating this switch will show the names of the colors in your canvas when you use the eyedropper, and also while selecting colors in the color wheel, or tapping in your color palette. Activating this other switch will add feedback with sounds to some of the sliders and switches in the menus. Okay, I think I have covered everything that's new in Procreate 5.2. As I said before, let me know if you have any questions in the comments below, and I'll do my best to answer. Also, if you enjoyed this content, make sure to subscribe for more videos, and give me a thumbs up. I post Procreate tutorials about drawing, painting, and illustration every week. If you'd like to support this channel, check out my Gumroad page, where I have tons of Procreate brush sets available, and I'm sure something will suit your artistic needs. All the links are in the description below. Okay, thank you for watching, see you next time!